Richard McLaughlin and John Bradley. If the audience could please stand their seats after this play, Mr. Brunson will be invited up to make his adjudication on tonight's performance. Thank you. Thank you.
Ripping off our sound effects.
It was good though, wasn't it?
I'm hungry.
anything wrong? I had it all worked out. What's the matter? With one more baby, I could have managed, but not with two. The welfare had already been on to me, Mrs. Lyons.
Twins? You're expecting twins?
How quickly an idea planted can take root and grow into a plan. The thought conceived in this very room grew as surely as a seed in a mother's womb.
Give one to me.
What?
Give one to me. I can't have children. Please, Mrs. Johnson, please. I'm that desperate to have a baby.
Each day I look out from this window. I see him with his friends. I hear him call. I rush down, but as I fold my arms around him,
he's gone.
Was he ever there at all? I dreamed of all the places I would take him. The fun we'd have, the stories I would tell. The jokes we'd share, the clothing I would make him. I reach out, but as I do, he fades away.
You're
Sally's gone and nicked the other gun, and it was me best one. Why does he always take me things off me?
It's because of the youngest in the
Mum, we were playing mountain policing Indians, and I was a mountie. And you know what? You know, this morning, I wiped out 3,000 Indians. Mum, you're dead.
Hey, just go outside and play, would you mind? You know it's a rule against up in the rough end.
We're down at the other end of the posse's near the park.
Mickey, quick, you say you're playing!
Oh, Mum, I'm sorry, I forgot.
What have I told you about playing up there?
It wasn't my fault, honest. It was the Indians, the ones up there trying to escape.
No, I don't want you playing there anymore.
But why?
Never you mind why, I have any reasons. Now just shut up and play outside the front door where I can see you.
I wish I was our Sammy. Our Sammy's nearly 10. He's got 2 worms and a catapult and he built an underground den. But I'm not allowed to go there, to stay outside the gate, because me mum says I'm only 7. But I'm not, I'm nearly 8. Sometimes hate our Sammy. He rode me to a car, you know. Now the wheels are missing and the top's broke off and the bleeding thing won't go. And he says that when he took it, it was just like that. Well, it wasn't. It went then straight. Well, you can't say nothing when they think you're 7. And you're not. You're nearly 8. I wish I was that Sammy. You should see him spit. Straight in the eye from 20 yards, and every time I hit. Now he's allowed to play with matches. I go to bed dead late. Well, I have to go to bed at 7, even though I'm nearly 8. You know what, Sammy? You know what he sometimes does? He wheezes straight through the letterbox of the house next door to us. I tried to do it one night, but I had to stand on a crate. Because I couldn't reach the letterbox, but I will by the time I meet.
Hello.
Hello.
I've seen you before.
Where?
You were playing with some other boys near my house.
Do you live up in the park?
Yes. Are you going to come up and play there again?
No, because I'm not allowed.
Well, my mummy doesn't allow me to play down here.
I wonder why. Doesn't matter anyway, because I'm really soft, aren't I? Hey, give us a sweet.
All right, take as many as you like.
Are you soft or something? Round here, when you ask for a sweet, you have to ask 20 million times, and they still don't think they can give you one. Sometimes that Sammy gives you a sweet. You have to be dead careful if that Sammy gives you a sweet.
Why?
Because he's usually weed on it first.
That sounds like super fun.
It is if you're at Sammy.
Do you want to come play?
I might too, but not right now, because I'm pissed off.
Pissed off? You say smashing things, don't you? Do you know any more words like that?
Yeah, loads. You know, like the F word.
Pardon?
No, the F word.
What does it mean?
I don't really know. But it sounds good though, doesn't it?
Fantastic. What's your name?
Michael Johnson. But everyone calls me Mickey. What's yours?
I'll call you Eddie. How old are you, Eddie?
7.
So am I. Hey, when's your birthday?
July the 18th.
So is mine. Hey, we were born on the same day. That means we can be blood brothers. Do you want to be my blood brother, Eddie?
Yes, please.
It hurts, you know. Right, give us your hand.
Right, this means that we're blood brothers and we'll always have to stand by each other. Now say after me, I will always defend my blood brother.
I will always defend my blood brother.
And stand by him, and stand by him, and share all my sweets with him.
She's all down the park.
That's Linda. She's a girl, but she's all right.
Hello.
Yeah, you come on down the park to shoot as I can.
Yeah, we tried. She's singing off.
I don't think my mother would let me.
Come on.
This one might knock you off your pedestal.
I know.
Nobody else will like you better than more.
It's just our bad luck to be just before this. Even the guy ballsed up his luck.
Yeah.
Mummy?
Yes, darling?
How do you spell bogeyman?
Hmm?
Bogeyman.
I'm trying to look it up.
Edward! Where did you hear such a thing? There's no such thing as the bogeyman. It's just a superstition. You know, the sort of thing a silly mother might say to her children. You know, the bogeyman's going to get you.
Will he get me?
Don't be silly. I told you. There's no such thing.
Oh, does any of you have come out to play?
Mickey!
Hi, Eddie. I've got Sammy's new catapult. It's brilliant.
Oh, do you go to the same school as Edward?
No. Mickey says smashing things. We're brothers. Blood brothers.
Yeah, we were born on the same day.
I'm sorry. You'll have to be going. It's Edward's bedtime.
All right. See you tomorrow then, Eddie.
I think you're very mean.
I told you, I don't want you going with that where boys like that live.
I don't understand, and I hate you.
Edward, don't say that. I'm only doing it because I love you.
No, you don't. If you did, you'd let me play with Mickey. I like him more than you.
Don't say that. Don't ever say that.
It's true, and I will say it. And I know what you are.
What? What?
You're a piss off!
Oh, now you see why I don't want you mixing with boys like that! Oh, my son, my beautiful son!
And so continued for the next 10 years. Despite their mother's tears and protests, they haven't even got a care, apart from deciding what they're gonna wear. And who dare tell the lambs in spring the fate the later seasons bring? Who tell the girl in the middle of the pair what price she paid for just being there.
Martin, the thing is that when you go charging, they got theirs out. And I think that'll count for us.
What, 3 nights instead of 1 night?
Yeah, it's the same, but we have Shakespeare now.
Trip to the beach, but everything is possible, the world's within your reach. and you don't even notice broken bottles in the sand, the oil in the water, and you can't understand how living could be anything other than a dream when you're young, free and innocent, and just 18.
Scene?
Yeah, but for some reason they skipped it. I'm glad we said nothing, but come on, I have to try and get the queue to order.
Can I speak to Councillor Eddie Lyon, please? Hi, Eddie. I need to talk to you. In the park? All right.
There's a girl inside the woman, like the mother she became, and a half-remembered song comes to her lips again.
Why didn't you call to see me earlier?
I heard your friends. I didn't like putting in.
You could never be butting me. Look, you might as well know I'm never going to see you again. I've always loved you.
I suppose I always loved you in a way.
Then marry me.
Didn't Mickey tell you? We got married last Christmas. I had a baby. But I'd still like to see you now and again. Like this. That's all right.
Of course.
The girl would sing the melody, but the woman stands in doubt and wonders what the price would be for letting the young girl out. Same thing.